Taylor Powers. RJ Stovall. For Cooper Castle on the drum set. We'll be right back. Well, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We are so overjoyed to be here. This is not our regularly scheduled concert that we normally do in the spring semester. Normally, we have the Bryce Luty Jazz Festival on the last Thursday and Friday in January. But we felt that we would be better served if we were kind of push our concerts back a little bit and try to get a sort of survey of the situation. So we're super happy to be here. And I will just off the bat say that we have not totally scratched the Bryce Luty Jazz Festival. As a matter of fact, the next jazz band concert that we do will be April 20th. That's a Tuesday, also at 7 p.m. And so that will be our celebrity concert that will be the Bryce Luty Jazz Festival concert. And our celebrity guest artist this year, fabulous trumpet player from Chicago named Victor Garcia. So just going to get that plug out of the way right off the bat. So anyways, that first tune you heard was by Nat Adderley, a great cornet player, brother to maybe the more famous Cannonball Adderley. But if you have any Cannonball recordings, he would always record with his brother Nat. So we were able to kind of stretch that out. I don't know if you guys noticed, but we were making up backgrounds. There was really very little planned there, other than I guess the solo order and maybe some shtick at the very beginning. But you know, this is the spirit of jazz. Jazz is all about improvisation. And let's hear it for the improvisers that we heard there. Let's hear Ethan Pearson kicked it off on trombone. And then Ethan is one of our music majors. Another music major of ours, Taylor Powers, on the vibraphone. Give it up for her. Another music major, RJ Stovall, on the trumpet. Another music major on the piano. Give it up for Patience Carmen. And let's see here. We also heard from Adam Cooper on the trombone. And finally, he's a freshman with us this year, but man, he is like full of energy. I love it. Let's hear it for Cooper Castle on the drum set. All right, and that was a Nat Adderley tune called Hummin'. All right, we're going to move on here and do something kind of like a little closer to the big band tradition. I think it's still kind of like, this is a little bit more like Santana, Oye Como Va kind of vibe. It's by this jazz guitarist named Jack Peterson called Mongo Tungo. We'll hear from a couple of the soloists on this one as well. So Mongo Tungo. Saxophone. Glenn Velasquez on the trumpet. Thank you very much. This is called Mongo Tungo, but I'm sure a lot of you are singing like, oye, como va, in the backgrounds there. So all right, I think we're going to move right along here. So of course, like, this concert really has a lot of focus on big band music. And so I tried to draw from as many different big bands as I could. And so this next one, although it's not the Benny Goodman arrangement, Benny Goodman certainly made this next song famous. And I would like to just give a special kudos to our soloist on this tune, Johnny Huggard. He's playing a tenor sax solo closer to the end of the tune here. But you'll see him playing bass in the concert jazz band. So one of our many multi-instrumentalists here, and Johnny has really done a fabulous job for us. So just want to say, yeah, man. All right. So without further ado, we're going to slow it down now. This is a beautiful number called Moonglow.
Thank you.
Alrighty. We've got one more tune for you here. I guess now would be a good as time as any to just get some thank yous out of the way. It does take a lot to put these concerts on, especially that we're sort of adding strings to the concert as well. We feel like we have the ability and the flexibility to be creative here at Hutchinson Community College. And so we're always trying to think of new and spicy things to do with our programs. But doing stuff like that does really require a lot of energy and effort. So I want to say a huge thanks to David Planthold, who is operating our stream and our video for tonight. So this concert also it's streaming live on Facebook, actually on YouTube as we speak. And then it will also be archived on YouTube as well. You can check that out at the HutchCC channel on YouTube. And another huge thanks to the students that are working as far as like backstage lights, and to Shane Dawson, who is our technical manager here. He's working sound, and he's really helped to get our sound really dialed in. So huge thanks to those people. And also, she was taking tickets for you when you came in, but our secretary, Susan Evans, she does a whole lot of work to help us be able to put on these concerts. So thank you to you people. We really appreciate it. So it's kind of funny. We had actually been preparing a bunch of music for our jazz festival concert on January 28th, and we had been working on some really hard stuff. And we're still gonna play some of that really hard stuff in April, but we threw together some new music here this semester. Like I've been talking about, like it's got the thrust of being about the big band, and sort of in following in the tradition that's set forth here by Bryce, Luty, and by Daryl Batchelor, we do want to make sure that we have some audience pleasers in here. And it's been a couple years since we've pulled this one out. So what better time than now to bring you guys Glenn Miller's really famous tune, In the Mood. So Jazz Lab Band, In the Mood. Thanks for checking us out. And the strings will be after us. All right, so here we go. In the Mood. Thank you. All right, we're going to switch over to the string orchestra real quickly here. And after the string orchestra, we will take a 10-minute intermission. So stick around. We will be right with you.
little bit of a runaround here. So thank you for sticking around for the string orchestra portion of our program. We're keeping our portion a little bit shorter this evening since we will be joining the concert jazz band in just a little bit. I'm sure y'all probably recognized the classic tune, What a Wonderful World, and we're going to keep on with our slight nod to the world of jazz with a tune made famous by Nat King Cole. You may recognize it from either, well, our social media posts the past week or any number of other things, including the Disney movie, The Parent Trap. So without further ado, this is L-O-V-E. One last thing before we go to intermission. If you're wondering when you'll be able to hear the wind symphony, the other major wind band that we have here, March 7th, we're actually going to be taking a trip over to the Hutchinson Zoo at 3:00 in the afternoon. That'll be a free concert. We'll have lots of good music, and as you might imagine, most of it is animal related. So stick around after intermission for the concert jazz band, and you'll see these lovely people once again for a couple of those charts as well. So thank you. Have a good evening.
Alrighty, yeah. So first tune of the night there for the Concert Jazz Band. I think maybe some of you might have been a little bit maybe disappointed that you didn't hear the song from War, the cowbell, anyways. But no, that's an original tune by this California saxophone player, composer named Dave Leach. And it's always the story. Those of you that come to these concerts regularly to hear the jazz bands, I'm always talking about the library downstairs, and it is massive. And an activity that we do all the time is we read a lot of music, and oftentimes they'll tell you, I bring it into the band, I have no clue what it's gonna sound like. So I brought this in, Lowrider, sure. And the beginning was like, what? You hear those alto saxophones? Like, what? What is that? And it took like 10 times, I think, for me to convince them those were the right notes. But it's like all this tension, 37 bars, no drums, like, and then it just locks into the groove. And it ended up, first time we ever did this was with the Lab Band, and it was our favorite song, so I thought this would be a good kind of, good sort of rock swing tune to play. So anyways, give it up for the soloist on this one. You heard from Blaze Graber on the trombone. Yeah. Hey, all right. More vibraphone from Taylor Powers. Yeah. she's like really playing everything here. It's like the all-star of the concert, I guess. So awesome. We'll get you like a plaque or a medallion. Okay, anyways. And also, who else did we hear on that one? Oh, it was just two solos. Okay. All right. Well, we're going to move on now. In the theme of our big bands, we're going to do some Duke Ellington. It's not always so easy to really do some great Duke Ellington. He was active from early on. When he was 18 years old, he had his own professional band. And by 1927, he would have been 27, 28 years old at the time, he had a regular gig at the Cotton Club in New York City, which is a really big deal, but it was really kind of a bizarre snapshot in time. And so we're really trying to capture that. So we're actually going to do a tune from 1936, this next one, and also a tune from 1930. And so this is the earlier Ellington period. This is my eighth year here, and this is really the first opportunity I've gotten to have so many clarinet players in my saxophone section. So I've threatened them since the very beginning. I'm like, do you play clarinet? And they're like, yes, I do play clarinet. And so anyways, but we have three clarinetists in our saxophone section, I think. Is it three? Oh boy, I'm really bad at counting. We have four. Okay, so we're gonna do two Duke Ellington numbers. This first one is from 1936, and this is a little bit more of a straight ahead tune and not a Cotton Club tune, but this is a great song. This is gonna feature, I believe it features Tucker, Brecken, and RJ. Anyways, hope you guys enjoy this one. I think it's a really nice swinging tune. This is called Uptown Downbeat. On the clarinet. Thank you. Thank you very much. And I'm just going to go ahead and straight up steal this from Duke Ellington. We love you madly. We're going to do another Duke tune right now. This is one that is from the Cotton Club period. And this would have been part of the stage shows that the Duke Ellington Orchestra would put on. They'd have dancers. And they're just painting a very kind of specific kind of dark picture. This is another tune. I've had this on my list of tunes to play for years and years and years, maybe even like before I came to HCC. I was like, I want to do this with a band. So this is going to feature our clarinet section over here, and just gonna make her a little nervous, but Paige Staggs is playing lead clarinet. We're also gonna hear a solo from Paige Staggs, so I'm super thrilled that we have that. Also, we're gonna hear from Andrew Schoengert and from Blaze Graber on this one. This is Duke Ellington's The Mooch. Andrew Schoengert on the trumpet. All right. right, I'm going to invite our string orchestra to actually come back here and join us. Hence the title of the concert, Big Bandemic with Strings. I really appreciate that marketing and that the president of the college let me kind of throw in like a reference to the pandemic for this concert. I kind of just sort of documenting like this point in history and in all hopefulness, like sort of our emerging out of what we've had to all endure for the last year. So originally we had this concert scheduled with the Hutchinson Symphony Orchestra and the String Orchestra. And Hutchinson Symphony Orchestra couldn't quite conceive how they were going to have such a large group to do this. So we had to improvise, but you know, fortunately, jazz people do that improvisation thing. That's kind of their thing. So I was talking with our director of bands, Chris Merchant, about like, yeah, what can we do? Can we have jazz? I was trying, can we get the jazz bands on that concert? And of course, he's such a good guy. He's like, you betcha, you know, let's do it. And I was like, let's not just have jazz band and strings. But like, there's a long history of jazz musicians that recorded with strings, and it is never anything but amazing. Especially Charlie Parker with strings, I think it's just a wonderful album. In my opinion, in my heart, it just fits perfectly. So we're gonna do two charts here that features various students in the band, and we're backed up with this wonderful string orchestra that we have here. I kind of slapped together some string arrangements because these jazz band arrangements didn't originally have them. But I'm really super, super happy with how this all turned out. So first tune that we're going to do is going to feature one of our freshmen. He's a music major, trombone player named Chase Miller. And we're going to be doing this tune. It's going to feature, it's a medley of Tommy Dorsey tunes. And it's not a chart that is published or anything. It's just in our library. And inevitably, I wish I could tell you what year it was, but it would have been a year that Bryce was here. Or Batch, I guess, brought in a guy named Eric Berger as a trombone soloist, and he just brought this chart with him. So we just kind of added to his chart. But in this one, you're going to hear I'm Getting Sentimental Over You, Marie, Song of India, and Boogie Woogie. This will feature DeMarcus Meyer and our string orchestra, and of course, Chase Miller. So I'll invite Chase up here to the mic and let this sort of be his show here for the next one. This is Tommy Dorsey Medley. Okay, well, we've finally come to our last piece of the evening. So just another thank you to all of these wonderful students for being flexible. They really do amaze me because we've had to go through now three exceptional semesters that I don't think that Mr. Merchant or myself ever thought that would be part of our professional careers. But anyways, so let's just give it up for the students, all right? So, very nice. All righty, so the last piece we're gonna do here is a Thad Jones, original composition and arrangement. He did write horn parts. I almost said French horn, but you see, I'm being trained by our horn instructor here. Anyways, and if you don't know, it's not the French horn, it's the horn, all right? It's if you are French and you're playing the horn, I guess you could call it a French horn. Okay, anyway, sorry, I get distracted. So back to the piece that we're doing. So Thad Jones did write the arrangement for two horns to join this, so I did take some of those horn parts, but I took a lot of liberties as far as adding strings and just trying to boost up a lot of this. So it's kind of bombastic. I think it's really interesting. This is just the third movement in a three-movement work that's called the Freedom Suite or the Suite for Pops. And so this is a dedication to Louis Armstrong. I would say this, it's kind of peculiar. You'd be hard-pressed to really hear any Louis Armstrong in this whatsoever. So, I don't know, maybe Thad Jones could enlighten us on how this is a tribute to Louis Armstrong. It does feature Timber Allen and Kristen Howard playing a little trumpet duet in this. We're gonna hear from Taylor Powers again on the vibraphone. I know you guys heard a little bit of DeMarcus Meyer there, and you're like, I want more. And so we're gonna give you some more DeMarcus Meyer. For Mr. Merchant and myself, we wanna thank you guys. Having an audience here is everything. The energy that you guys bring to us helps us to perform. And so this is just like a step for us I'm just gonna be cliche, to feel normal again. So we're on our way, we will get there. So thank you guys very much. And our last piece is called The Farewell. Thank you. Bryce Miller, Demarcus Meyer, RJ Snowball, Braxton Lumen, Andrew Schoenger, Taylor Powers, Chris Merchant, String Orchestra, Concert Jazz Band. Thank you guys very much.
Lionel Hampton.